Today I'm going to teach you how to even out an uneven green screen using a classic VFX technique. So if you've ever gotten a green screen that wasn't super even, this one's for you. So I'm going to get started by just blowing everything away. So I'll walk you through step by step on what's going to happen. We're working with a linear image. So it's Asus CG. I've got view LUTs turned on. Let me move this over here to the side so you can see view LUTs enabled. The other thing to know is this is in Float 16 right now. I'm in Fusion Studio 20. I need to be in Float 32 for all this math to work properly. So I'm going to load a CD, a change depth node, just to change it. So we're working in Float 32. And we'll start using a clean plate tool. It'll be the first step here. So the clean plate tool is going to help preserve our edges. So to do this, I'm going to actually open a second viewer so I can actually do my color picking, not on the result. And I'll grab my background color for the clean plate. Just click hold and drag. If you hold command and drag, it gives you a little bit of a sample box. If you still had some noise left in your denoise plate, it'll average things out a little bit better. There we go, that should work. I'm gonna hit the viewer that has my clean plates in it. We'll come in closer. I've got beard hairs in there that I wanna try to retain that detail. So in the clean plate tool itself, you've got a road slider. So I'm just gonna take the road slider to push out. And the area that is not showing here will be included so that I'll be able to work with that. I do see an issue down here that I'm going to try to get back. So maybe I wrote it too far, because the next step you do is you grow those edges. And I'm going to grow them as far as possible, maybe even hit the fill button. And there's our clean plate. So that's the first thing. We've got a clean plate built. And this whole thing is built in a way so that if we need to refine and get detail back later, we just come back to that clean plate and adjust. Now the concept is we get a perfect green color that we apply everywhere, and we just use subtraction and addition to do that. So where do we get our perfect green? I just grab a background node to do that. Really simple. Color picker, we're gonna sample a color over here. Let's command or control drag to get our sample larger. So we're getting an average. Let's say this is our perfect green that we're gonna use for keying. There it is. We're gonna use this. Now, this one is also float 16 and it's also the wrong aspect ratio. So let's adjust this so that it matches the rest and it'll work mathematically. I'll go to the image part of background. I'll change this so it's vertical video. It's all TikTok-y. 1080 by 1920, the depth is gonna be float 32. There, now this image can work. Now, channel booleans is sort of the secret to doing mathematical operations in Fusion. So we're gonna grab one of those, shift space, BOL is the shortcut for it. And I'm gonna use a lot of channel booleans in this setup, to be honest. So I'm gonna leave this to the side so I can just do a lot of command C and command V. So command C, command V, and I'll try to label these as we go so you can follow along. Change this here to subtract. This is the first step. Alpha is gonna do nothing. So subtract, do nothing. And we'll take, let's label it. So F2, subtract. We're gonna take the ideal green, we're gonna subtract the clean plate from it, and this gives us a defect map. And so to get this defect map applied to our original footage, all we have to do is add them. Pretty simple. Command C, Command V, change this subtract here to add, give it a rename, F2, add, and so we're adding the original footage to the defect map, and now I don't have myself held out or cut out yet, which is what we're getting to next, but I do have the exact same color green filled all around. So I need to create a mask, and the best way to create a mask in Fusion is the delta keyer. So let's get a delta keyer down here. So shift space, delta keyer. And the way the delta keyer works, I'm gonna give myself more room as I work. Delta keyer needs footage in the yellow background input. So if there's footage, I can actually go ahead and use a clean plate that I already pulled into the pink clean plate tool that's built into there. And if we take a look, I hit A for alpha. I've already got an alpha. It's not good enough yet, but you know, it's a soft matte that's gonna get us pretty far. You can see there's some detail there in the beard. I'm gonna fill in this hole with a secondary key that's gonna be called my core matte. That's gonna live, it's gonna be a harder matte that's gonna fill in things like the Yankees cap there. That's not doing so good. There's some weird flickering going on, so maybe this clean plate needs a little love. So maybe I come back over here, adjust that erode a little bit. There we go, that's a little bit more solid now on that clean plate. So now on this delta key, or what we do to create a core map from it is I just do a copy of it, Command C, Command V. I'll give this one a name as well. Let's just call this, could be, yeah, just call it core. Sure, that works. And this one also gets the image to pull the key, and it gets the clean plate. So that's the same, it hasn't changed yet. But if you go to the mat tab of it, and actually let's see if we can use this right here is our view LUT. If you gamma slam this down, it's gonna make hole, it's gonna show alpha holes. Like if I zoom in here, you can see my alpha values down here. They're not fully opaque, it's 0.988. So this is gonna give me an opportunity to really try to make sure that I'm filling in all the holes. Take the threshold slider here, drag this white point down a bit, somewhere around there seems to get everything. I'm looking at it super gamma slam, so you know it's not going to be as bad once I lift that back up, but I do need to erode it. So this is my edge key, this is my core mat. I need this to fit inside it, so I use the erode dilate. So this just sort of shrinks it on inside there. I might need to blur, pull this back down, and I'll plug my core mat into the soft edge mat by just taking the output of it, right clicking to hold so I can say solid mat. And there we go, I filled up those holes. So I've got a nice mat that I can use. Now I'm actually gonna pull a key on the clean plate as well. So not just using the clean plate to create the key, but also pulling a key on this. So in this step, actually I'm gonna disconnect this add because we're gonna mask that off before we do our actual add. So I'm gonna take this delta key here and create an exact copy of that key to key the clean plate. So Command C, Command Shift V, that gives us that green line. It just means they're the same values. And this one's gonna get footage from the clean plate. It's gonna get the clean plate from the clean plate. And it's gonna get the solid mat that we had created over here as well. So that's gonna go into solid mat. So this is one of our mats. That's from our clean plate. This is from our footage. And now I need to invert them and divide them. So there's no invert built into the delta key itself. So I will do that with the channel booleans. Command C, Command V. To invert with channel booleans, you change it to negative, okay? So let's give that a name as well. Negative, or it could be invert, whatever you want to do. But here's our original mat. Take this into here. There, it's inverted. Command C, Command V. We're also gonna invert the key that we took off the clean plate. Okay, so there's that one. I've inverted both of these keys. Now I actually need to divide one by the other. So I'm gonna take another channel booleans, Command C, Command V. This one's gonna be set to divide. Let's give it a name, F2, divide. I'm gonna take the key that came from the image itself and divide the clean plate key. And that gives us this result. I've hit C. It's kind of some crazy looking colors. You can see down at the bottom, we're definitely into negative values, and that's the beauty of floating point, is we can go into these crazy negative values and recover them to get a perfect result at the end. I wanna use this to multiply, but I need the alpha in the RGB channels. So the next thing I'm gonna do is shuffle into the RGB. I'm gonna do that with another channel booleans, Command C, Command V. And we'll go right into here. I'm gonna change the name of this one to shuffle RGB. And to do that, I'm gonna take the alpha from all of these and put them into red, into green, into blue. And it's a copy operation is what the shuffle is. It says FG, but if there's nothing in the green FG input, it just takes the yellow. So take a look at this. Now, this is my image that I can use as my mask with the defect map that we did just a few minutes ago. All right, so I'm gonna take one more channel booleans. This will be our final channel booleans. And this one is gonna be set to multiply, do nothing to the alpha, to multiply, and so we'll multiply our mask. It doesn't add more, this order doesn't matter because it's commutative. And right there is our result. So to get this stuck back to our original footage, all we have to do is add it together. So I'm taking our original footage, which went red for some reason, I don't know why. And we'll do our channel booleans add with our defect map that's been masked off, stick it into this add. And now we've successfully evened out the green screen completely. If we want to check details and stuff, check before and after, let's do that. I will hit the period key to hit my before, which is the original footage. I'll hit my slash key to see our wipe. And there's before, after. Always fun to see before and after. Let's check the beard. Okay, we lost a little bit there, so maybe I want to recover like down in that section. So the nice thing about this is if I just go back to the clean plate, which was what was protecting that, if I maybe erode that out a little bit further, so you can see I've pulled some of that extra detail there on the edge of the beard back. So this setup is really, really flexible. If you take a look at my cursor, it's the exact same color green all over, and I still retained all of that detail is still completely there. I haven't damaged the plates at all. Please ask me any questions you got. Maybe let me know if I'm doing something incorrect, because I'm learning, just like we all are. See you next time.